Hey, Julie.
Hi.
All right, you ready?
Oh, listen,
I've traveled every road in this here land. I've been everywhere, man. I've been everywhere, man. Across the deserts bare, man. I breathe the mountain air, man. I've traveled, I've had my share, man. I've been everywhere.
Hey, Julie.
I like your virtual trucking.
Yeah, you like it? You're in the White Lightning. Welcome to Bandwagon TV Quarantine Confessions.
I love it.
Cool. Well, hey, thank you so much for doing this. I know it was somewhat of a last minute thing, but, you know, I know it's important to all musicians, and especially what you guys are doing is it's somewhat of a struggle. So any type of platform that I can give to somebody like yourself, I know we've never met in person, but I'm excited to tell everybody who you are and get this show on the road.
Yeah, thank you very much.
You're welcome. Well, hey, so we are in Austin, Texas, picking up Julie Nolen. Give everybody a little bit of intro about yourself.
Well, I have been here in Austin for over about 20 years now. I've been playing around here for quite a while. But I'm originally from Abilene, from West Texas.
Okay.
So I got a little peppy there, too. But yeah, I'm just a good old country girl.
How long have you been, I guess, singing and performing?
Oh, I guess about just under 20 years. I guess about 18 years now.
Okay. Are you coming from a family of musicians?
Not a whole lot. Somewhat on my mom's side. Some of my more distant family, they're a little, there's some church singers and stuff like that. They do really well with that. But yeah. I got a few like distant cousins, I think, that have tried to be a singer before too.
Uh huh.
But nobody's really doing what I'm doing right now.
Well, cool. So being from Abilene, I mean, it's not a big city. Was it a big adjustment moving to? And I can tell somewhat of your personality on Instagram. You know, being known as Julie F. and Nolen. Was it a different scene coming into Austin?
Yeah, sure was a little bit. I remember when I was 8 years old, it was my first time here to Austin, and my parents, we came here for my sister's UT orientation thing.
Uh-huh.
And I remember walking down the drag with all the drag rats, the punk kids with all their, you know, mohawks and crazy piercings.
Keep it weird.
I remember thinking, this is where I want to be.
Yeah.
All the freaks and the weirdos.
That's right. I mean, I've had to cut my hair now to fit in. I'm rocking a mohawk right now for quarantine.
Nice.
Well, cool. All right. Before we get started, what are you doing to stay sane during this quarantine?
Well, as you may have just heard, I got a couple of cats in here that are keeping me entertained.
Uh-huh.
Sure. I've been walking a lot.
Yeah.
It's actually something I've been kind of wanting to get more into. I just never really had the time. So I've
cool.
been
exercising.
I haven't walked like this since I'm 20 years old.
Yeah.
And I've been working on some just guitar skills, just learning some new stuff.
That's great. Well, good for you. Well, all right. So I'm going to pull over the White Lightning. We're going to get started. Now, just to let you know, we're not officially sponsored by Whataburger, but, you know, if they're around and looking for something to be a part of, they're more than welcome. I just love their sweet tea and hamburgers.
Yeah, all right. Absolutely.
So, I am pulling this bad boy over, and we are going to get started. Are you ready, Julie?
I'm ready.
All right. Sounds good. All right. First question of the lightning round. Julie Nolen, if you had to pick a musician, an artist, between two, Bonnie Raitt or Lyle Lovett?
Bonnie Raitt, through and through.
Okay, well, I kind of thought you would say that so quickly because if you ever get a chance, and hopefully you do, listen to Julie, her voice is just so unique and kind of that's how I got, I'm so glad that she was able to reach out and we were able to collaborate and do this, but you do, you have a great voice and you can somewhat sound, you do have that Bonnie Raitt sound, but I love it.
All right.
If you were deserted on an island, what band would you have to keep you company?
Oh my God. You know what? I would have Fleetwood Mac because they would never have any. They wouldn't have They would never not have drama. It would always be something interesting to watch.
That's a good, you know what, not just for the music. I mean, I'm sure Stevie Nicks would.
I mean, the music's great. Yeah. You know?
Yeah. But you need drama to keep you entertained.
But yeah, they'd be totally entertaining.
Yeah, I completely agree. Great answer. All right. Favorite album?
Oh. I mean, what year? What class? What genre?
Recent albums, say, whatever.
Dearest to my heart, I would say probably Willie Nelson's Pretty Paper.
Okay. And obviously Austin Boy right there. This one, yeah. I don't expect a immediate answer, but I find it interesting, and I love when a musician has something to say. Favorite lyric that you've written?
I would say, that's a good one. Well, I think for a musician, it's always going to be probably the latest song, right?
Yeah.
But I guess one of my newer songs, my favorite lyric would be Tumbleweeds Always Roll On. Will you crash and burn, or will you lose yourself with every turn?
I like that. Okay. All right. Well, we look forward to the new music, too, that we can get to here in a second. All right. And then just a few fun ones. The last two. Like us all common folk, we've been wearing a lot of the same clothes. Julie, you have to tell the truth now. Have you worn the same pants 2 days in a row?
Absolutely.
Yes.
More than-
All right, well, you don't have to say anything else because I am wearing literally the same sweatpants now for the last 5 days. All right, and then last question. What is the first thing you'll do once this whole quarantine thing is over?
Oh, my gosh. I'm going to head straight to wherever my friends are and hug their little necks.
It's lonely out there right now.
It is.
Well, thank you very much, Julie, for participating in the lightning round in the White Lightning. All right, so before you get into your music, plugs, social media, where can we find you? How can we listen to you?
All over the place. I'm on Spotify, Apple iTunes, Amazon, Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, all over the place. It's just Julie Nolen. And Nolan's with an E.
Cool. And I will also post when this goes live that I will have the tags and everything set up so you can find her in links. Upcoming events. I saw that you have a live show here coming up on Monday. Do you want to tell everybody what's going on?
Yeah, every Monday I have been live streaming right here from my couch. And what I do basically is I not only play my songs and whatever, kind of chat with people a little bit, but I also have a friend of mine, different bartender friends that have been out of a job also because of this, everything shutting down.
Yeah.
I have bartender friends of mine come on and they kind of personally like say, hey, or whatever. I call it working the show kind of where they just sort of like pop in, say hi.
Uh huh.
And then I have a song called Hey Bartender that I've been playing for years.
Mm-hmm.
It's my like salute to bartenders basically. So when I start playing that song, I tell everybody, okay, go ahead and close out your tabs, you know, and tip your bartenders and stuff like that. So I give them a chance to kind of support their favorite bartenders that they've seen
cool
around as well.
Oh, that's great.
Yeah.
Awesome. Well, we look forward, and I'll post something about that here too coming up on the Monday. You also said that you're working on a music video. Is that for what song is that for?
That's actually for the Hey Bartender song as well. Back in, I think, maybe August or September, we recorded a live version with the band.
Okay.
And so we have a live music video that's coming out. I've been kind of sitting on it for a while, waiting for the right time to release it. And now seems like a good time. So we'll be releasing that probably at the end of April. And I'll also kind of attach some of my bartenders on that too, so you can help out some local bartenders and bartender unions and stuff like that.
Cool. Is there any other bars or restaurants that you want to plug while you got a chance? I know Saxon's a big part. Yeah. They've been a big supporter.
Yeah, Saxon's been one of my home bars for a long time now. The Saxon Pub, if you've never heard of it, get your head out of the sand. It's one of the legendary clubs here in town.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Across the street, there's also been One-to-One Bar. They've been very good to me. And their bartenders have been really good friends of mine. I got Rustic Tap, of course, too. I work there. I do a lot of their buying and stuff like that. And I run a song swap there every Wednesday in normal life. So the Rustic Tap, I got to give a good shout out to them, too.
Cool. Well, Julie, we really appreciate you coming on, Bandwagon, yeah. All the way from Austin, Texas. I'm glad that I was able to swing by, but I got to kick you out. And before I kick you out, right. We're going to demand a song. So what song are you going to sing for us today?
Well, I think I'm going to sing Hey Bartender for you.
I love it. All right, the floor is yours. Go for it.
This is Hey Bartender. There's always someone out there you can rely on. Always be there waiting for you, leaving that light on. Some places I'm a rock star, some places unknown. Either way, there's always a neon light calling me back home. Always someone out there waiting on me. Always be the very last one.
Kicking you out, but hey, have a great weekend, okay? Stay safe out there, wash your hands. Remember, social distancing, all right?
Okay, thank you.
See ya, Julie.